Hi, I'm Rachel Gaskin, and you're watching ECITV.
G'day, everybody, and welcome to ECITV, episode 27. How you going, Gazza?
Not bad. Yourself, Shane?
Yeah, good, good. It's a bit more of an intimate show this week. We've only got the two of us.
Very touchy-feely. I love intimate shows.
It's not that kind of intimate, but... You have to pay extra for that one.
I think we're all excited because we are so close to being able to finally get together again and maybe restrictions reduced come Sunday night.
Yeah, so it might make for a slightly different show when Gary and I can actually get together and show you some more stuff in the studio.
Been a while since we've been together, mate.
I know, I think it was episode 2.
Yeah, we should have called it the ECITV Skype show. That's all it's been. But anyway, that's okay. We've battled on through and managed to hopefully entertain a few people out there during these COVID times.
I know, I've been entertained.
Yeah, that's true. No one probably watches you. Like, bit of fun recording. But look, things are going to change very soon and we are going to be able to get out and hit a few. Oh, not necessarily race meetings, but I think our plan is at this stage to maybe hit some gate nights and a few clubbies and just see how everyone's fared through COVID and what their sizing's like on their bikes.
In their race pants. I know, I've gone up a size.
So looking forward to hitting the... hitting a couple of little race meetings or gate nights over the next few weeks and hopefully bringing a few different perspectives on how people have got through COVID and how excited they are to be back with their mates and on tracks.
Sounds like fun.
Yeah.
So we've got a fair bit of general discussion. I guess I'll kick it off.
Yeah, I want.
IRC Tires are available again in Australia from December. So the guys over at CTD Industries who do Wheelwiss, ProStart, and a few other different brands, they're bringing them in. And so far they'll be available from Geelong Cycles, and I'm sure there'll be a few other bike shops jump on board with the IRC tyres. I think their most popular tyre of recent time, which hasn't been available in Australia yet, is the... Siren Pro, which is designed by Sam Willoughby, and it's apparently tubeless ready. So I'm sure there'll be a bunch of people excited to get those on their bikes.
I know years ago when we had Total BMX, IRC Sirens were massive. Like in the BMX side of things, the Maxxis and IRC were, you know, sort of fairly big brands back then, and the IRC Siren was a very, very popular tyre. So it is strange that they dropped out of the Australian market. So it's good to see it back.
They were a pretty soft tread, weren't they? They wore out a little bit quick, yeah.
But that made them grippy.
Grippy, so, yeah.
So it's good that the people at CTD Industries have been able to get them back into Australia because I think they'll do well.
Yeah, LUXBMX have been doing some more fundraising with the Shaun McCarthy Brain Battle Raffle. You had some involvement in that, didn't you? Supply them a bike or something?
Yeah, we supplied them a Element Cruiser to raffle off, and from what I've gathered, the tickets are selling reasonably well.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure I saw a post on social media saying they've raised $2,000 so far, and I think it's still running, but... the $5 ticket could win you a Chase Element Cruiser and a Factory Connor Fields Chase jersey that's been personally signed by the Olympic champion. So it'd be a pretty cool prize to win for $5 and a good cause.
Yeah, it's a shame the jersey's not a new one. I have noticed that Bruce has been wearing it around a little bit for some photo shoots. So you'll even get a little bit of Bruce love with it.
Not everyone can say that.
No.
Also, this past fortnight, Colt Vans have been released. So they're a BMX-specific race shoe, a collaboration with the BMX manufacturer Colt. And it's another one of my favorite styles, the old-school BMX shoe. So have a look at the picture. Will pop up on the screen if you like it. We're not sure when they'll be available in Australia, but pretty certain they will be. Every other limited edition BMX shoe has been, so keep an eye out. Paul Knox, our tech guy, that I don't think he's been on the show with us yet, has he?
We keep calling him our tech guy, and I don't think he's done anything technical yet.
He often sends me emails of new products, so he has done a little bit of research for us. He found this Stranger Ballast headset, which really is a progression of the standard 45-45 Campagnolo headset. So obviously, you got your two bearings, you got your bearing race for the fork. Instead of having separate wedge, top cap, and a little spring washer in between on top, it's just a single wedge dust cap all built into one. So that lowers the stack height and simplifies the whole system. So it'd be interesting to see if they take off in the BMX race scene, but I wouldn't mind getting my hands on one. Mm. I think that'd be quite nice.
Definitely. They do look good. They look very simple. Yep. And like you said, a very low stack height, which is what a lot of people are after. So that's that could work quite well.
Yeah.
Good concept. Anything that's simple is good. That's why you and I work well together.
So there's no answer, BMX, show us your bike this episode. We did get one bike. Thank you, David Gosling, for sending yours in. It's been so quiet, I actually had to do a test myself. So you might have seen that one come through, Gary. So hopefully, you need to check your email more.
No,
hopefully, hopefully we'll get more people submitting their bikes over the next 2 weeks and we'll be able to run that again. So don't forget to send your submission through ecitv.com.au/bike. It's a pretty easy form to fill out, but let us know if you have any problems and we'll give you an alternate email address. Over to you, Gary. You got some news for us.
Yeah, a couple of new things have come in. We've had the Alienation. OS 20 seems to be picking up a little bit more popularity. And we've had the OS 20 Alienation rims come back into stock. So they're available now through your local store.
Are they black only?
Black only. They are like a semi-gloss black. Not the satin black that you used to with the Malice and Mischief, and they're not a full gloss black. They're sort of like a semi-gloss and universal for forward or front or rear braking. So, they do have a braking surface on them and just the one design. But, yeah, for those OS 20 Tragics out there, they are available. Along with the OS 20 11 Forks, they're in stock at the moment in black only, and they're suitable for a 1-inch straight steerer or a 1-inch to 1.5 tapered steerer. So they're in stock, and we have the OS 20 tires, I believe, coming in from V Tire next week. So like I said, for all you OS 20 Tragics out there, we do have you covered at the moment. So hopefully once the tires are in, we can fully fit out your bike and get you back rolling around. So, yeah.
I think Paul's looking forward to having a crack with those VOS 20 tyres.
Yeah. He's, actual fact, just behind me. Where's it gone? Someone stole it. Oh, no, I've moved it. There's actually an OS 20 frame sitting here that Paul was going to jump on. Our tech guy. Another thing that's come into stock, which has been out for a fair while, and this is for all you retro gurus out there, is the Profile Retro 40th Anniversary Crank Set. Now, this has been around for 10 years. I mean, it's the 40th anniversary. They're now past 50 years in business, but this was one that they produced as a replica of the original retro crank set, celebrating their 40th anniversary. And that is a incredible chroming on that crank arm. It does come with the stickers to go onto the crank arm there. You can actually apply those decals yourself and you do get two spare. So it comes as a full kit. We've only got them in 180 at the moment. Comes with the bottom bracket, the spindle, the retro spider, a crank tool, And at the moment, we have old school BMX has basically grabbed our whole shipment. So if you shoot over to old school BMX, and they will have full stock of these by midweek. We'll ship these out to them Monday, and they'll have them midweek. So yeah, jump over and see Mark or talk to Mark and see if you can grab a set of these. So they are very sought after and fairly hard to come by. They only available at the moment in 180 mil length. Hopefully we'll get some 175s in shortly.
I did have a look at oldschoolbmx.com and they've already got a pre-purchase. I think it was on eBay as well. Got a pre-purchase set up for these. So I'm pretty sure there'll be people all over them before they even arrive on Wednesday.
Yeah, I think they'll sell out very quick. So if anyone is keen on grabbing a set of those, put your pre-order in because, yeah, they are very limited. And like I said, Mark's grabbed the whole shipment and we'll try and get some more in. But, yeah, that's about it for that. The other thing we've got coming in on Monday is some Stay Strong bags. So we've got the bike bag coming in. We'll pop some photos up. We've got quite a few photos, so we'll just flick through them a bit. So the new Stay Strong bike bag will be in on Monday, and that's totally new design with new material, new storage. We've got a little video clip that we'll put up at the end of the show, just that one of the riders, I believe, has put together as a little social media video clip, just showing the simplicity of the bag. It is a slightly oversized bag, so it will take a cruiser, as opposed to majority of the other bags, which are a bit tight for a cruiser. They generally fit a 20-inch quite well. We've also got backpacks coming in, Stay Strong backpacks, which are pretty cool, and they do have a raincoat configuration with them. So if you are out and you're riding around and the skies open up and you're in Melbourne, there's the built-in rain jacket that goes over the backpack to stop that from getting wet. We've also got helmet bags, Stay Strong helmet bags coming in, which are a great design because there's a incorporated cavity underneath the helmet bag that takes your race shoes and goggles or whatever. There's wet airing pockets on them. And yeah, there's a lot of thoughts gone into those. And the other thing we've got coming in is some Stay Strong cross body bags. So it's probably like an oversized bum bag, I suppose. It's just, I don't know, not something I'd probably wear, but I'm sure there's people out there that would wear these. But yeah, it's a cross body bag. Again, we'll show a picture of those so you can get an idea of the concept. And yeah, so they're all coming in Monday, and hopefully we'll have the V tires in by the end of the week.
Oh, that's a fair bit of news. I don't think we've presented quite that much news over the past, 27 episodes before.
Oh, there's a fair bit of stuff happening. So yeah, we've been fairly busy here pumping out some wheels. I think we had 8 sets of wheels to build this week. So we've had a couple of helpers in with Ryan that you would have seen on the show quite a bit. And Andy, our wheel builder, has come in as well to help us out with pumped out a few carbon wheels that you would have seen on social media. So yeah, it's been a bit hectic here for the last few days, even though we were shut Monday and Tuesday due to a horse race. Yeah, we had to play catch up for the rest of the week. So hopefully, even with all this stuff coming in next week, we should have a slightly easier week.
Do you see a lot more wheel sets going out now because things are freeing up COVID-wise, or do you think people are getting ready for Christmas?
No, I think all of a sudden everyone's jumping on these bikes and realising that, you know, when they went into COVID on a set of 1 1/8 wheels, they've come out of COVID on a set of 1 3/8 or 1.5. So, yeah, it seems like there's a lot of upscaling on a lot of products. We've noticed that even with handlebars, frames, everything, you know, all of a sudden that, you know, kids haven't been on their bikes for 6 months and all of a sudden they jump on and realize that they've grown 3 inches. So
if I'm going to follow trend, I'll have to get some OS20s too to cope with my OS diameter down.
Yours is about girth, not height.
So. Oh, that's right. 2.1 tyres then.
But yeah, so there's we have noticed a lot of sales on upscaling. So there's a lot of customers that have obviously, ordered, from 2-inch bars to 3.5s or whatever because they've needed to go up. So yeah, there's been quite a bit of that. But yeah, it's been a little bit hectic here, but we have got a good crew and it's we've got through it pretty well.
So. Oh, good. Yeah. So there's a couple of events we got to talk about. It has been quiet on the event front since everyone's had their state championships, everyone but us, that is. So Track Attack recently announced that their dates have changed slightly. So they'll be running racing from Friday the 8th of January to Sunday, January 17th. So the format's about to change as well, but the way they're running their dates is Friday, Saturday, Sunday on both weekends. Which should help it make it a bit more achievable for local Victorians rather than running midweek races on the Tuesday and Thursday like they had in the past. So they've got more announcements. They still haven't announced the format of the event. And running BSX, we're in the same kind of situation. It's hard to make any real solid concrete plans given COVID restrictions right now. We basically wouldn't be able to run it the way things are. But hopefully over the next 2 months, things will free up a little bit and we'll get to race Track Attack and get to hold a good race here at BSX as well.
Shane and I have had a fair discussion in regards to this prior to going to air in regards to the changing of the days. And it's hard to try and work out the advantages or disadvantages because you can obviously see both. But the advantages, obviously, is that it makes it more of a weekend-orientated event, being a Friday night or presume a Friday afternoon, Saturday, Sunday event, which frees everyone up midweek to be able to race that weekend. But then, is it less attractive to the interstaters and everything that would come down because it was a solid week of racing? So it's hard to see how it's going to affect either positive or negative the Track Attack series. I personally think it's a bit of a positive. I like the idea of trying to keep it on the weekends, and it's very difficult for people to get away from work and everything like that, even though I know it is sort of semi-holiday period. But to have that midweek racing has always been difficult. It's attractive, but it's always been that little bit logistically a little bit difficult. So it might increase numbers by having just more weekend orientated events.
So I know the Tuesday and Thursday events ran quite late. So if you were to take the day off to get to those events, you'd almost need the day off the following day to recover.
Yeah.
So being a Friday, it kind of, which bleeds into the Saturday, it's less of an impact on the parents to try and get away from work. And I think it'll work. I'd like to be able to do Track Attack one day because with BSX, we're always flat out on the first weekend and then too knackered the following weekend. So a different setup like this, it might be potentially doable for someone like us who are normally busy doing other stuff.
See, the other advantage, I suppose, is that even though, there's a lot of good attractions down in Victoria to see. I know we get bagged a lot with our weather and everything like that, but there's some great attractions down here. And people who do come interstate, they come for that week of racing, but it doesn't really free them up any time to actually go and visit, the Great Ocean Road or Wilson's Prom or anything like that. So I suppose by having it as a weekend event, it frees them up midweek that then they can go and sightsee and they can see some of the tourist attractions that Victoria has to offer and then race the following weekend and bug off, So
that was always my pet peeve. If you go to a race meeting for 2 days interstate or, a few hours away and you're at the track the whole time and you don't get to actually enjoy that location. Like, I've been to Bendigo, I don't know how many times, but I had known nothing about Bendigo Township. I just know about the track. So it probably would help for someone who was traveling. It's quite a bit Melbourne has to offer. You might be forced to wear a mask, but you can still get around and see everything.
Like a new ECI BMX mask. Compliments of planet, what are they? Planet
I don't know.
Clothing? Planet. I don't know. Planet. We're just calling Planet. But yeah, they these turned up during the week, so they're a nice fitted mask that Jason at Planet had sent me. So keep an eye out for these. I will be sending them out to most of my profile guys and everything. So I apologise for not doing that up to this stage. Just been a bit crazy. So, but yeah, thanks to Jason. Well done, mate.
Getting back to events, IRC Tires have jumped on as BSX 2021's latest partner. So if you can't get to BSX because of whatever restrictions or work or whatever, there might be opportunities for you to win some IRC Tires. We're going to do a little bit of online auction just to make sure that we can, at minimum actually, to make sure that we can get more people involved in BSX. It's always a difficult time of the year for some people because they're supposed to go back to work that day, but we'll make it happen.
I'm sure you will. You always do, mate.
So now it's time for story time with Gazza.
Well, story time. Oh, one thing I forgot to mention before, sorry, in regards to these, they are all individually numbered. I only just noticed that. So where it says the 180 and this set is 1596, and the arms are matching both stamps. So sorry
that's
about that.
That's your date of birth, isn't it?
What was it? 1596. Yeah, pretty close. Feels like it this morning. So. Yeah, look, we're going to kick off Friday the 13th coming up, and that's a pretty important date for a few reasons. One is that it's my birthday.
Happy birthday.
And another one is that it's the release of the Ride BMX movie.
On Prime Video.
On Prime Video. So for those people that have got access to Prime Video, Friday the 13th, the Ride BMX movie is being released. And this is the, I don't know, we'll maybe even put the trailer up at the end of today's show. But it's a... It's a life story of a guy called John Buultjens, who we all know as Scottish John. I think everyone knows him as Scottish John. He had a pretty rough upbringing in Scotland and found BMX as his escape of his horrid life, and ended up pretty good on a BMX bike, ended up coming over to Australia, and I was fortunate enough to meet up with him when he came to Australia many years ago. He discovered, we used to run a BMX shop called Total BMX back in the day, and John discovered us and came into the shop, and we struck it off pretty well, struck up a pretty good friendship. And yeah, so we've known Scottish John for a long time. He even did a little bit of promotional work for us, and we'll pop up a quick image of John promoting TNT frames back in the day. He mightn't like us putting that up on public social media, but yeah, it was good days back then. But yeah, Scottish John was came to Australia, made a big impact here, made a lot of friends, did a little bit of part-time acting. I used to work in Pentridge Prison, and I even bumped into him there filming one day, a small show, I think it was about the Ronald Ryan escape or something. I'll have to find out from John exactly what it was about. But yeah, we've had a lot of dealings with John. He then started up a Pilgrim BMX and ran those bikes and everything for quite some time, and put a lot of time and effort, and just has got a real passion for BMX. He had an enormous Haro collection of BMX bikes, and he said to me one day that he had some exciting news, that he believed he's finally struck his dream job. And I found out shortly after that he actually was able to become the Haro BMX brands manager and move to America and work for Haro. And it was there that he ended up telling his story, and someone picked up on it and decided that it would be a good one to produce a movie on. And now we're at the stage where it's about to get released. So kudos to John. He's done a lot, and he's a fantastic guy. I've met up with him many times over the years, most recently in Taiwan, and we had a few drinks together. And and dribbled a bit. And yeah, so it's good to see that he's succeeded so well, and this movie's about to be released. So if you have the opportunity to sign up to Prime, jump on, just have a look at this movie. It's definitely worthwhile. So with, you never know, with a bit of luck, we might even be able to get John to have a quick chat on the show after the movie's been released, just to see what the reaction's like. I'm sure he'd love to. He's always up for a chat, Scottish John. There's no question about that.
I remember before Scottish John went to Haro, he had, must be the biggest Haro collection in the world. It was pretty much one of everything that was ever released. It was crazy. Mm. I think he sold it all, or at least he had it up for sale for a while.
Yeah, he ended up selling it all. And look, honestly, I believe he tried to sell it to Haro as a full collection. I don't believe they were interested. Now, look, I may be wrong here, but I know he did end up selling basically the whole collection. And I know he's just bought a house or a unit, you know, and I believe that was funded through selling his collection of Haros. So that's how extensive the collection was that enabled him to get his own place over in the States.
It's definitely a retirement fund for him, wasn't it?
Oh, it's massive. And look, if we can find the image, there's a few pictures getting around of him standing in front of the collection, and we'll pop it up. But, yeah, massive. And, yeah, very interesting guy. If you ever get the opportunity, he's very approachable. He'll always be up for a chat. And, yeah, fantastic guy. And hopefully... hopefully he does so well out of this show and this movie, and definitely worth having a good look at it.
Great. Maybe he'll return to acting.
No, I think he's always been in acting. I think his whole life's an act.
So you think they'll start calling him Hollywood John instead of Scottish John?
I think it'll always be Scottish John. Always be. He's got a very broad accent. For someone who's been in Australia for so long and now in America, yeah. He's got a very strong Scottish accent, and a lovely guy though. But yeah, it was a pleasure to be a friend of his for many, many, many years. So, yeah.
All right. Well, that's it for story time with Gazza, and it's it for the show. But before we go, you did touch on it being a birthday on Friday the 13th. So rather than saying happy birthday after the event, happy birthday from me and all the viewers.
Thank you.
Thank so you. What, 21st again?
Yeah, well, actually, it's almost three of them.
Oh, shit.
It's almost my third 21st, yeah. Yeah, it's actually, 62.
All right.
Yeah, so, yeah, at least I'm not keeping it a secret like someone else did 2 weeks ago.
That's a month ago now.
Oh, is it? Bloody hell, time flies when you're locked up. Okay, everyone. Well, I think that's about it. A short, sweet show, but please look forward to jumping on to our next one, because we will finally be able to, after 25 episodes, be able to get out and actually talk to some riders. So it's been hard times here with our lockups and the COVID situation, but there is a light at the end of the tunnel, and the whole concept of this show is to bring you some race results and some interviews with riders and some antics on the road and all those sorts of things, which we've never been able to do. So if this show has survived through COVID without any of that, hopefully there's a lot of good things to come in the future. So please keep us in mind, and we'll bring some good content very soon.
Also, a bit of forewarning, Paul Knox, we're coming for you. We've got some tech stuff for you to do.
You certainly do. Yeah. So, at least we can get together and film a bit of this stuff rather than sitting here at a computer on a Saturday morning or Friday night or whatever and just talking to a camera. So, everyone stay safe out there, and I look forward to talking to you again very soon, hopefully with a bit more content.
All right. See you guys.
See you, Shane. See everyone. Mate. Stay safe.
Blop, I thought you'd prefer blop, not to see my face.
Blop. Yeah, but I can see. I couldn't see the good part of it, just the hat. You blanked out the wrong part. You need to blank out the face and leave the hat.
I can turn my camera off. That'll be the way to go. So I need to tell you, Gary, that we're recording this call for legal...
You what?
For legal obligations.
I'm not going to say anything. I'm going to sit here and just be quiet. You know that's impossible. I give you approval to record this call, okay?
Thank you.
So that's all, folks.
I've heard that you can't choose where you come from, but you can choose where you go from there.
I promise I'll be a good boy!
My life wasn't always like this.
We got ourselves an Aryan brother.
Choices I made led me closer to the edge. They led me to something I never thought could be real.
I found you a potential family.
It's a pleasure to meet you, John.
I told them your story, because this is your only shot. And you'll be eligible for adoption.
They pay a guy like you enough to live like this? I thought only athletes and rappers made this kind of dough.
I'm a specialist in my field, fixing problems others can't figure out.
You really think you're gonna like El Dorado High School?
I'll get out here.
You're embarrassed to be seen with my husband? You are a fool.
That's my son. Anybody know where I can sign up for the parent-teacher conference?
Stop.
Why me?
Everybody deserves a second chance. What do you think?
Trying to buy me? Every day
I
wake and
everything is broken. I can teach you how to ride a bike. All right, keep kicking. Oh, I got you.
Nice. BMX. It's like the rite of passage for the kids who are out of place.
Listen up, BMX Nationals. It can only take 5 of you to show if you deserve to be one of those 5.
Oh. Think it was gonna be easy?
I'm never gonna be anything, just like my father.
What did you think?
Eldridge was accused of assaulting a white woman on a college campus.
So he didn't do it?
No, he was innocent. Eldridge fought his way back, John. So can you. I can't sit and
hope, I can't just sit and pray. What's wrong, Johnny boy? You ashamed of your family?
You don't want to do this. You know, we looked at hundreds of files of kids, and he chose yours. He saw kindness behind that hard exterior. Breathe,
baby, breathe. Stand up, John. When things get tough, remember that they told me I'd never have a son. I can't just breathe.